I'm USA Today Motorsports Insider Jim Aiello, standing here at Indianapolis Motor Speedway and getting you ready for the 103rd running of the Indianapolis 500. So far this week, the story has been David versus Goliath. Some of the Goliaths have already gone home. The Davids have made the show. It's been phenomenal drama here at IMS. The first, of course, is Team Penske. Roger Penske has won 17 Indianapolis 500s. His driver, Simon Pagenaud, is sitting on the pole. Will Power, his other driver, is sitting as the defending champion. Roger Penske, no doubt, is going in as the favorite to win. He also has Helio Castroneves pursuing his fourth Indianapolis 500, putting him in exclusive company. And that doesn't even count Joseph Newgarden, who is the burgeoning face of IndyCar. He already has an IndyCar championship. Now he's looking for the 500. On the other side, we have Andretti. Andretti and Penske have won the last five Indianapolis 500s. Marco Andretti would be the biggest story probably to come out of Indianapolis if he were to win. He would break the so-called Andretti curse, which Mario Andretti hates to call it, but it would be on the 50th anniversary of Mario's fabled win at Indianapolis Motor Speedway. And finally, who's going to win the 103rd running of the Indianapolis 500? I'm going to go with one of those underdogs. I'm not going to pick a Penske. I'm not going to pick an Andretti. I'm going to go with Ed Carpenter of Ed Carpenter Racing. And to be fair, he's probably not an underdog in many people's eyes. If you've been paying attention to Indianapolis the last few years, he has had some of the quickest cars at this track. This year is not excluded.